Greetings, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, people of all ages. Welcome to Painfully Honest Tech, Tech So Honest It Hurts. Today, this episode of Painfully Honest Tech is dedicated to all of the intrepid leakers and rumor seekers out there who are doing the yeoman work of providing unsubstantiated and sort of questionable leaks and rumors for us, the rest of the people who want to talk about tech, to have something to talk about while we're here with no real tech to discuss. Thank you for your sacrifice. Now, let's get on to talking about the news. Anyway, I say the news, but is it really news? We won't know. But what we do know is that there are some things out there that people are saying probably are going to happen. One of which is new iMacs. We've known that for quite a while. There's going to be new iMacs. They're going to look a little bit more like the Pro XDR display, whatever it's called. And that will be a good thing. There hasn't been a new iMac design since, I believe, 2010, which is a long time. And yesterday, intrepid leaker, our good friend of the show, John Prosser, came out with some information that may or may not excite those of you out there who are big fans of, say, Necco wafers or the Barbie Dreamhouse. The iMacs are rumored now to potentially come in the same colors as the iPad Airs, which is like silver, some kind of black or space gray, pink, green, blue, you know, just all kinds of really nice pastel-y colors, which is awesome. Isn't it just absolutely awesome? I mean, think about how a pink iMac will look on your desk, how a blue iMac will look on your desk, maybe a green, a fuchsia. Maybe we'll get fuchsia. Who knows? As long as it's pastel and as long as it looks like it came out of a Necco wafers pack, we will be good. I mean, honestly, John put together a render of what they might look like. And honestly, in this picture, they look like this should be the iMac 8-bit line. It looks like something out of the game Crossy Road, and just really not all that attractive whatsoever. I mean, sure, these iMacs are going to be fantastic, and they're going to have the new M1 chips in them, or the M1x, or whatever they're going to call these new chips, and they're going to be unbelievable in terms of the performance. But I can say without a doubt that the majority of people who are going to go out and buy an iMac are not likely to buy a colored iMac. Now, Apple is, of course, trying to play the nostalgia card like they did with the new iPhone design earlier or later last year. They're trying to do that by bringing back colors. But the thing about the colors on the original iMacs, the Bonnie Blue and all that kind of stuff, that was coming at a time when all computers were beige boxes and everything was just kind of ugly and the industrial design was not all that interesting. And Apple wanted to stand out and be sort of something different than the rest of the pack. That was really their entire deal. They wanted to be something different. And so they came out with this all-in-one design with these crazy colors on them, and they were something different. And those machines were revolutionary. But the thing that's changed at this point is that Apple no longer needs to stand out from the rest of the pack. I would say that Apple is already sort of the cream of the crop of the desktop and laptop computing world. And a lot of the people who want to use iMacs in their homes are using them maybe for a quasi-professional reason. A lot of businesses buy iMacs to use in their office spaces. I can't see there really being that much of a market for a pink iMac, but you know, maybe it's just me. But honestly, I will be personally disappointed if we get like a plethora of pastel iMacs to choose from. I guess it doesn't matter in the long run. But then again, I think about things like the iPhone Mini, which is now being taken out of production, basically, as far as I've heard, because no one wants to buy it. It was the cute little iPhone that could, and it couldn't, so now it's being taken out of commission. People buy computers so that they sit on their desk for an extended period of time. I mean, several years, if not 5, maybe even sometimes 10 years, you will have a computer that sits on your desk. And that computer usually is supposed to accentuate your desktop setup or the overall decor of your room or office or something like that, instead of being the piece of equipment that mandates the color palette. And I can't think of a single bedroom, office, or office space that could really bring in a light blue or a pink or a green iMac and make that work. But hey, I'm just the old guy here to complain about things. This is Painfully Honest Tech. What do I know? You'll let me know down in the comments below. Now we have a story that's kind of the total opposite of this story, which sometimes Apple confuses me because it's like one hand doesn't talk to the other. Everybody has complained for these 5+ years that the MacBooks, when they were redesigned in 2016, they didn't have the ports that everybody wanted. In fact, they didn't have any ports that people already used. They had these USB-C Thunderbolt ports that were just everybody had to buy new stuff for and all that kind of stuff. They didn't have the MagSafe charger, so that made people mad because MagSafe has saved many a person's computer from getting yanked onto the floor. There were a lot of things about the previous design that were fan favorites, let's call them. And Apple, basically, when they redesigned the MacBook in 2016, they took all of those things out. And they put in the USB-C, as we talked about. They also put in a touch bar, which hasn't necessarily been controversial because not too many people have used it. And they brought in the butterfly keyboard, which we've talked about ad nauseum for as long as we could possibly think of to talk about it. The butterfly keyboard is now gone the way of the dodo. And if reports from Ming-Chi Kuo, who's usually also very good with his rumor leaking, reports say that now Apple is going to bring back the SD card reader, which is a professional port that most professionals need, and the MacBook Pro. So SD card reader, HDMI port is coming back, which, okay. And then they're also going to bring back the MagSafe. Apple, it's like poop or get off the pot. You're either going in one direction and you're leading us in that direction, or you are looking very indecisive at best. I guess we should celebrate that these ports are coming back because it will minimize the amount of other stuff that we have to have attached to our computers in order to make them useful. However, by this time, 5 years out, the people who needed to use their computers in a professional manner and needed to use a MacBook for whatever various reasons have already purchased hundreds of dollars worth of extraneous things that they attach to their computer so that they can use them without the ports that Apple has taken away. So yay and sort of an FU from Apple on both sides. I don't really know what to think about this. I want to applaud, but yet I also want to shake them and just say, why? I almost forgot. They're also going to take away the touch bar. So any of you who have gotten used to using the touch bar and integrate it into your workflow, well, you won't have it anymore once you buy a new MacBook. This is sort of nitpicking, I'm sure, because the new MacBooks are fantastic. The M1 chips are amazing. I'm using one right now to record this entire thing. There's nothing really to complain about except for the fact that in true Apple fashion, they never seem to really know what it is that they're trying to do from one moment to the next, from 1 year to the next, from one half a decade to the next. So we have pastel-colored, Necco wafer-inspired iMacs coming, and then MacBooks with the ports that we never wanted to have gone back. Let me know what you think down in the comments below. If you want more of these painfully honest takes on the news stories of the day, then you're going to have to hit that subscribe button and come on back and see me again. Won't you now? Thanks so much for being here. My name is Jason. This is Painfully Honest Tech. Tech so honest it hurts. Until the next time, I'm out.